Okay, start. Yes, am I audible? Screen is visible, right? The screen is visible. Yes. Okay. Yes. So let us start. So let us continue from last topic itself. Okay. So we have stopped at a certain problem. Which is that problem number? Do you remember that problem number 22 or 23? Somewhere we stopped, right? 22. Okay. Please check whether it's the same problem or not. Okay, after completing these problems, we can move on to next topic. Okay. Yes. Whether is that same problem? Is it same problem? Yes. Okay. So. Yeah, good. So how to solve this? I told you about the trick, right? So I told you about the trick. Yes. So what do you get? What is the answer? How to solve it? Anyone? Yes, it is 32. So first, what do you have to calculate here? First, what do you have to calculate? The large number of capacitors rating 5 microfarad and 200 volt is available, right? So first you need to design, the minimum number of capacitors required to design 10 microfarad, 800 volt. So you need to get the value of N. Yes, so how to get the value of N? One minute. Yes. So first you must get value of N. So how to get value of N? Yes. That is 800 divided by 200. That means designed value divided by, what is that? Given value. Right, designed value divided by given value. So what is designed value? That is 800, right? Divided by what is given value? Given voltage, that is 200. So what do you get? You'll get 4, right? Yeah, 4. Then you have to get value of M, right? So here also, designed divided by given. Just go through the equation. Into N you have to write. So what is designed here? 10. So given value is 5. Into N, that is 4, right? Yes. So what do you get? Sorry. Yeah. So here what do you get? 40 by, yes, here it is 8. Correct? No, you'll get 8. Yeah. Now to get total number of resistances. Sorry, what is that? Capacitors, right? So total number of capacitors. How to get it? Yes, N into M. So 8 into 4, that is 32. Correct now? Yes, all of you got it, right? Yes. So very simple method. Okay, using this equation directly you can solve. Okay, yes. Shall we move on to next one? Yes, just go through this. Here comes next question. The figure gives the electric potential V as a function of distance through 4 regions on x-axis. So which of the following is true for magnitude of electric field E in these regions? See, this is actually V and X graph, right? V and X graph. So you have the relation E equal to minus dV by dx, right? You have V E equal to minus dV by dx concept. So from this, if you want to get electric field, what do you have to do? You have to get the slope of that. Yes, you have to get slope, right? So E is nothing but minus dV by dr. Just calculate slope of this region. It is horizontal, right? This line is horizontal. That means it is along x-axis. So what is slope here? Slope is zero, right? Here slope is zero. Similarly here, what about slope? Here also slope is zero. That is also horizontal. That means at A and at C, electric fields are same, right? EA equal to EC, right? Both have same slope. Both have same slope. Now, come to this. Come to this. What about this? This is somewhat positive slope, right? It is positive slope. Of course, this one is negative slope. Negative slope. But which one value is more? If you consider B and D, in this, which one is greater? This one is greater, right? This is more slope. Slope is more. Here, less slope. Less slope. That means if you consider B and D, if you consider EB and ED, so which is greater? If you consider EB and ED, which is greater? Yes, ED is greater. So we can consider like this. Correct? No? Yeah. Now what is the answer? Yes, that is option D. EA equal to EC and EB equal to ED. EA equal to EC and EB is less than ED. Yes. So option is D. Correct now? Yes. Shall we move on to the next one? Yes. Just go through this. So how to calculate this? What happened? The capacitance of parallel plate capacitor is 12 microfarad. If the distance between the plates is doubled and area is half, I think you can do it directly. C equal to epsilon A by D, right? So C dash. So what happens? Distance is doubled. That means this becomes 2D and area is half. So what do you get? Yes. What do you get here? This is actually C by 4 you will get, right? C by 4. So what is C? C is 12. So 12 microfarad divided by 4. So what do you get? 3, right? 3 microfarad. Simple question. Simple one. I hope you can do this. Right? Shall we move on to the next one? Yes? Yes. Okay. Next. Here comes one more. Common potential. I think this one, you did it, right? You did it. So direct formula, I will give that formula, C1V1 plus C2V2 divided by C1 plus C2. You can do it now? Yes. How much you got? 200? Yes? Yes. Okay. Then, let's move on to the next one. Yeah, Cp by Cs. N number of identical capacitors are connected in series. Yes. What is the answer? Yeah, Cp and Cs. Just write the expression for Cp and Cs. So what is the expression for Cp? N times C. What is Cs? C by N. So Cp by Cs. Nc divided by C by N. So what do you get? N square. Correct now? Yes. So let us move on to the next one. Yes. How these are connected? I'm going a little bit faster. Okay. So I hope you all of you have gone through these questions. Okay. Yes. So for some of the questions, I will give hints so that we can start next topic today. Okay. How these are all connected? How all of these are connected? Yes. Series. Whether they are connected in series? Is it in series? Please check. Is it in series? No. They are connected in parallel. So when you can say that if there are certain capacitors, when you can say that they are connected in parallel, for example, if you have two capacitors, okay, then if one terminal of them is connected to one common point and other terminals are connected to another common point, then these are connected in parallel. Similarly, if you consider one more, if it is like this, yes, then it is connected in parallel. Same happens here. Just look at this point A. One plate of first capacitor is connected, second, third, fourth, like this you can write. Okay, so one plate of first capacitor is connected to A. Then from second capacitor also, it is connected to A, one plate. Then from third capacitor also, it is connected to A, right? Now, you need it from fourth also. See, just look at this. From this one also, it is connected to A. That means out of all four capacitors, one terminal is connected to this A. If other plates are connected to another common point, they are in parallel, right? Therefore, just look at the point B. So from first one, yes, it is connected to B. From second one, yes, it is connected to B. From third one, yes, it is connected to B. And from fourth one, yes, it is connected to B. That means this is actually like this. Right? Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes? Yes. First capacitor, second, third. Sorry. 1, 2, 3. This should be here. Right? 4. So this is A. This is B. Correct? No? So all capacitors are connected in parallel. How many capacitors are there? N equal to 4. So connected in parallel. So what do you get? Each one has value. How much? Each one has value. Yeah, 8. So what is the answer? So what is the answer? Answer. Tell me the answer. Yes, 32. Correct? Correct? Yes? Yes. Right? N times C. Correct, no? Okay. J. Let's move on to the next one. This one, shortcut formula you can use. Correct, no? So what is shortcut formula? So you have two charges. What are those two charges? 12. One is 12 and another one is minus 6, right? 12 and minus 6. So they are separated by a distance of 20 centimeter. Okay. So somewhere here, you can consider it as x1, right? So at this particular point, what is that? Potential becomes 0. So how to calculate that distance? X1 is nothing but x divided by q2 divided by q1. Whether you have to consider minus or plus? Plus or minus here? Plus or minus? Minus, minus. Very good. Minus, right? That is minus. Why? They are unlike charges. For unlike charges, you have to consider minus. You can just substitute that values, right? So what is that distance? 0.2, right? Centimeter, you can convert that into meter. Then what is Q2? Which is Q2? Which is Q2? Which is Q2? 12 or 6? 12, yes. Divided by 6 minus 1. So you can calculate this. What do you get? What is the answer? Anyone? Option, which option? C, option C. Yes, very good. So just look at this. So if you know these tricks, directly you can solve. How much time we took now? Only 10 to 15 seconds. Yes. Okay. So within 30 seconds, you can solve. Okay. Yes. Yes. Just look at this. Just look at this. Have you gone through the question? If you close this, then what happens? As soon as you close this switch, then current flows through this, right? So that this capacitor starts charging. This capacitor starts charging. Okay, this capacitor starts charging. So until this gets charged, during charging, what happens? The current goes on increasing here. Initially, current is zero. Initially, current is zero when this switch is open. If it is open, current is zero. Then when you close it like this, when you close it, what happens? Current starts increasing. Current starts increasing. Right? So when current increases, what happens? This will glow. This will glow. Whether it continuously glowing? No. Till this capacitor gets a charge, this glows like this. Okay? When this capacitor completely gets charged, then what happens? Then flow of charge stops. Right? If this gets completely charged, then flow of current stops. Then what happens? This glow will go. Right? So what is the answer? Which is the option? Yes. Right? So the bulb will light up for an instant when the capacitor starts charging. During charging, it will glow. Okay? So when that capacitor completely gets charged, that will stop. Okay? Yes. Yeah. This one, yes, What about this? Yes, it is like common potential concept. Hope you can solve this. Okay, so how they are connected? How these are connected? They are connected in series. They are connected in series. So at this particular point, you have to calculate potential. Yes, yes. So I think you can do this. Yeah, what about this? What about this? Yes. See, how these two are connected? How these two are connected? How they are connected? Series, right? So that becomes C by 2 equal capacitors. So this one also C by 2, right? So we can rearrange the circuit. C by 2, okay? And I will take these two together, okay? So one more C by 2. And this C, I will write it here. Okay, I will write it here. C. Now, just look at this. These two are, how they are connected? Parallel. These two are connected in parallel, right? So what is the its effective value? Effective value, two equal capacitors connected in parallel. Yeah, that becomes C. So we can write it as C. Its effective value is C. Along with that, you have to add this one. So what do you get? Yes, C and C. C and C. This effective value and this one. So what do you get? Answer. Yes, that will be 2C. Right? So C, C parallel. So you will get 2C. Correct? No? Is there any doubt? Is there any doubt regarding this? No. Yes. Yes. Okay. Then we can move on to the next one. Yeah. We can answer to this. Effective capacitance of capacitor is reduced to minimum, to get minimum value. How you have to connect? Yes. Yes. Okay. Now, what about this one? If you look at the potential, see, this charge is at the center. Charge is at the center. Now, point A, distance from point A to charge, point B to charge, point C to charge, point D to charge. All these distances are same, right? Same, right? Yes. So, that means what? This is nothing but equipotential surface. This circle is nothing but equipotential surface. So that means potential at A, that is equal to potential at B, potential at C, potential at D, right? Therefore, if you want to move a charge on equipotential surface, this is equipotential surface. Equipotential surface. So what is the work done? What is the work done? Work done is zero, right? Work done will be zero because potential difference delta V is zero. Therefore, A to B, A to C, A to D, A to E will be zero. So what is the option? C, correct? Yes. Okay. Nice question, right? Yeah. Just look at this. It looks very large, right? But method of solving this type of question is very easy. How to solve this type of question? You can use a trick here, okay? You can use a trick. See, if you look at the options, no need to solve all the, you no need to solve this using the dielectric constant or C equal epsilon A by D. Don't use all these concepts, okay? Directly you can solve. How? Look at this. This is actually equations, right? These are all equations. So, in an equation, left side has to be balanced by right side. Correct? So, just you put, say, look at this. Here you have K. Now, instead of this K1, K2, K3, K4, you just put it as K. So, what do you get? K plus K plus K plus 3K. Now, add all this. Whether it is same as that of left side? Just check. K plus K plus K, 3K plus 3K, 6K. So what do you get? K equal to 6K. K equal to 6K. Is it correct? No. No. Yes. Now come to next one. Next one. Here, what do you get? K, K, K if you put. So what do you get? 3K plus 2K, 5K. Again, whether it balances LHS and right RHS? No. Next, come to next one. Next one. Here, K. K, K, so what you get? 3K, right? So what you get here? In this, you can write 2 by K equal to 3 divided by 3K plus 1 by K. So what you get? You will get it as 1 by k plus 1 by k. So 1 by k plus 1 by k is nothing but 2 by k itself. 2 by k itself. Correct? No. That means LHS equal to RHS. So you can select this one. That is the answer. How is this trick? How is this trick? Yes. If you want to solve, then series parallel combination, right? Series parallel combination. You have to use. That is very lengthy process, right? So use this type of trick. Okay. Within 1/2 minute. How much time you took now? 30 seconds, right? So within 30 seconds, not even that much time is required. Okay. So directly you can solve. So use this method. Okay. Yes. Good. Yeah. This one you can answer. So what is the answer? Right. Yeah. Next, this one. What about this? What about this? How we can solve this? So you can just name these points. I will name this as X, this point as Y. Okay. And here, somewhere here, this point, I will name it as F. Okay. And let us consider this point as D. This point is D. And this is E. Okay. E. Yes. Now, this one is actually B, right? This is connected to B. This is also B itself. So now try to rearrange this circuit. Try to rearrange this circuit. It looks somewhat complicated. Okay, this looks somewhat complicated. So just rearrange this. How to write this? Say, to point B, this capacitor is connected. Or just look at this point B, Y, and E. They are interconnected, right? All these are interconnected, right? Yeah? Yes, they are interconnected. So I will consider that point here. This is B, Y, E. All are connected together. So from Y, there is a capacitor like this. Okay, this is X. Correct? So this capacitor I have considered here. Okay. Now, next one, from B to F, there is a capacitor. So from B to F, let us consider this as F. See, just look at this, F and A. F, A and A are same. They are interconnected. There is no capacitor in between. There is no capacitor in between, right? So what you can write? This point is nothing but A and F. Same point, A and F, same point. Okay, yeah. To that, one more, say, just look at this. Okay, B is over now. B, Y, E is over here. Yes, next, just look at this. From E to D, there is a capacitor. From E to D, there is a capacitor. So that capacitor I will consider here. This is D, okay? E to D, there is a capacitor like this. Then one more, this one you have to represent, between A and X. That means here, I can represent this capacitor here. Okay, and one more left, this one, between X and D. So here, correct? Now, this is actually what? This is Wheatstone, right? This is Wheatstone. So all are having same value. Then what about effective value of this? Effective value of this will be equal to C itself, right? Effective value of this one equal to C itself. But now one more capacitor left here. One more capacitor is left that is connected between F and D. So what you have to do? You have to connect that between F and D, C, right? Now, if you consider this one, this is Wheatstone network. So its capacitance will be C, right? So now this C is connected in parallel with this one, right? So what do you get? You will get a circuit like this. You will get a circuit like this. C, C, right? This is A. This is D. Now, two equal capacitors connected parallel. So what do you get? Yes, N times C. That is nothing but 2C. Is it clear? Yes? Yes. So which is the option? Yes, option A. Yes. Okay. So just try to redraw that circuit like this. You have to redraw that circuit like this. Okay? Yes. Okay. Then, yeah, this one you can do. Right? This one you can do. I hope you all of you have gone through the questions. Okay? Just go through. If you have not gone through the question, please go through that. Okay? So I am directly calculating it now. So you can redraw this circuit. Okay? Just stretch this. So if you redraw that circuit, you'll get a point A here, right? Point A, okay? So from here, you have to consider C2, then C1, and this one like this. I think you can draw like this, correct? Okay, you can redraw circuit like this. So what is this? This is C2, and C4 comes somewhere here. Okay, this is C3. And this is C1. How these two are connected? Parallel. So each one has value 9, 9. So what about this one? 18 you will get. Okay. So that 18, yeah, this 18 is in series with this one. Right? So this 18 is in series with this one. So what do you get? 18 into 9 divided by 18 plus 9. So what do you get? What do you get? 6, yes, 6, right? So total this value will be 6. Total this value will be 6. So that 6 is in parallel with this, right? So what do you get? 6 parallel with this one. What is this one? 9. So what do you get? 15. Is it there? 15 microfarad. Correct? Correct? Yes? Yes, very good. Okay. Shall we move on to the next one? Yes. Okay. Yeah, this one you can do. This one you can do. As for this problem, you know, CS is nothing but C by N and one more CP equal to N times C. These two combinations are connected in series. So what you can write? C equivalent equal to CS into CP divided by CS plus CP. Hope you can calculate this. Correct, no? Just substitute the values of CS and CP from this. Okay, substitute these values. Okay? So, which one is you have to get? Option C you must get. Okay? Option C. Yes. Option C. Okay. Shall we move on to the next one? Okay. Yeah, just look at this. Just look at this. In this problem, actually, this is also negative. This one is also negative, right? So you can just imagine these two are connected together. Then how will be the combination? It is just like this. This is 2C. This is C. Okay. So this is negative. This is positive. Now what is the value? 10 volt. Now how these two are connected? Yeah. This is actually grounding. This is nothing but representation of grounding. Grounding means negative. Please remember that. Okay, this is nothing but negative. All are connected together. To ground means negative. Okay, to ground means negative. In such symbol, if you get, that is nothing but negative. Please remember that. Okay, now how these two are connected? Series. So what is effective resistance capacitance of these two? C and 2C, series. So what do you get? 2 by 3C. Correct? Correct? Yes? Effective. C into 2C divided by C plus 2C. So what do you get? Right? Yes. So 2 by 3C is given. So what do you have to calculate? Charge stored. Okay, charge stored. Q equal to CV. C equivalent into V. So this is C equivalent. Right? So what do you get? 2 by 3C into V. So what is C value? 6. C 6 into 10 power minus 6. What is V value? 10. Yes, can you calculate this? What do you get? Just calculate this. 40. Getting? Okay. Yes. Okay. Yes. So what about this? Next question. Not use the equation. Okay. I'll take 5 more minutes to solve these concepts. Okay. Later we can move on to next topic. Yes, 40. Question number 40. Dielectric medium concept. If you insert dielectric medium. Yes. Next topic is current electricity. Okay, current electricity. Yeah. So when you insert some dielectric medium, given that T is nothing but D by 2. T is nothing but D by 2. So which equation you can use? Which equation you can use here? C dash equal to, I'll write it from this point. Okay, so C dash equal to epsilon naught A divided by, what is that? Epsilon D minus T plus T by K. Correct? No? Correct? Yes? Yes. Now substitute the values. Substitute the values. So we can write it as epsilon naught A divided by D minus thickness is given D by 2 plus T by T is T by 2. So we can write it as D by 2K, right? D by 2K. Substitute T equal to D by 2. So what do you get? Epsilon naught A divided by D is common. Okay. Epsilon A by D is common. So here you will get 1 minus, what is that? 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2K. Correct? No? Yes. So now what is this? That is actually C. So C dash equal, we can write C divided by 1 minus half. That is half, right? Plus 1 by 2K. What is the value of K? Is it given? Either K value is given. That is what you need to calculate, right? The electric constant, that is what you need to calculate. C dash value is given. C dash value is given. What is C dash? C dash is 4 by 3C. That is equal to C divided by. So what do you get? Here. 1 by 2 into 1 plus 1 by K, right? Yeah. CC get cancelled. Just simplify this. What do you get? 4 by 3 equal to 2 divided by K plus 1, taking LCM, divided by, what is that, K, right? K. So 4 by 3 equal to 2K divided by K plus 1. Just cross multiply and rearrange for K. Okay, just cross multiply and rearrange for K. You will get K equal to, which one? Is the answer? Have you tried? Yeah. It is 2, yes. Just cross multiply. Okay? Is it okay? Yes. Shall we move on to the next one? Yeah. What about this? This you can do. First, what you have to calculate here? Potential difference you have to calculate. So, you know, potential difference V equal to Q by C. Right? V is nothing but Q by C. So potential difference across 2 farad you have to calculate. So you can consider 2 farad as C1 and this one as C2. So Q by C1 you can do. But first you need to calculate Q. So how to calculate Q? Q can be calculated as Cs into V. So to calculate V value, you know, this is V. But you need to calculate Cs first. So first calculate Cs. So whatever Cs, how these two are connected? They are connected in series, right? So effective capacitance. So what do you get? 2 into 1 divided by 2 plus 1. So what do you get? 2 by 3. Okay, 2 by 3. So substitute that 2 by 3 here into 12. Right? So what do you get? Here you will get 8. So substitute that value here. So 8 divided by C1. What is that? 2. So what do you get? 4 volt. Correct now? Yes. Okay. Okay. Simple calculation. Simple calculation. Okay. Yes. Yeah. Let us move on to the next one. Just move on to the next one. Yeah, this is direct calculation. E equal to half CV square. Okay, E equals half CV square. 0.06 joule you have to get. Okay, that you can do. Then, what about this? What about this? See, in this, you have to remember one concept carefully. Okay, here, 2 capacitors, soft capacitor, 3 microfarad and 6 microfarad are charged to a potential of 12 volt. Okay. Initially, it is charged. Then it is disconnected. Okay. And again, it is connected. Right? Again, it is joined. Once it is charged and then disconnected and again charged. Sorry, again joined. Then you have to calculate common potential. Okay. So you have to calculate potential difference across each, right? Potential difference across each. That means you have to calculate common potential there. Potential difference across each means common potential. So in general, when similar plates are connected, I gave 2 equations for common potential, right? When similar plates are connected together, and another one is opposite plates are connected together, right? So in this one, what is the case? What is the case? Positive of plate is connected to negative plate. That means second concept you have to consider. Common potential. Second, opposite. That means what is the equation? V equal to C1V1 minus C2V2, right? C1V1 minus. Yes, negative sign. Very good. Manvit, you're right. Okay. So negative sign you have to consider. So C1 plus C2. Just substitute the values. Okay. Just substitute the values. Got it? Okay. So you must get 4 volt. 4 volt. You must get 4 volt. Please check that. Simple calculation. Okay. So C1, V1 value you have. Right. So V value you have. Okay. Yes. This one. This is also very simple. Tau equal to PE sine theta concept. So you have to calculate which one? P. So P is nothing but tau divided by E sine theta. Just substitute the values. You must get it as 18 into 10 to the power minus 30 or 1.8. How much you are getting? Please check between B and between B option B and option C. Which one you are getting? I have substituted this. B. B or C? C. Okay, please check that. C. Most of you are saying it as C. Okay. Okay, please check. B or C? Yeah. 10 to the power, you have to check. Okay. So, what about this? What about this? Energy stored will be maximum. Energy stored maximum. What is the equation for energy stored? Half CV square. Right? So V remains same. So V, C must be maximum. When you get maximum C? To get maximum C, if you have 2 capacitors, if you connect them in series or parallel, in which case you will get maximum? Yes, in parallel. In parallel. Right? C is maximum in parallel. C is maximum in parallel. Correct now? Yeah. So, which is the option? C. 3 are in parallel, right? Option C. Okay. Yes. Yes. I think remaining one, you can work out it as a homework. Okay. So, if you want, I will give answers for this after the class. So, we'll wind up this topic here. Is it okay? Okay. If you want this one, see. This one, for this, I will give one equation. Okay. So when when n number of drops combine, We did this in fluids. Okay, this type of problems we did in fluids, mechanical properties of fluids. There, the relation between capital R and small r, you wrote, right? Do you remember this? Volume remains same. The relation between capital R and small r, right? Similarly, here also, when they combine, when n number of drops combine, please remember this shortcut formula. Potential of bigger drop, V is potential, okay, here. Potential. V is potential. It is not volume. Here, V is potential. Potential of bigger drop is given by n to the power 2 by 3 potential of smaller drop. Please remember this equation. Okay. Potential of bigger drop is n to the power 2 by 3 potential of smaller drop. So here we can write potential of bigger drop, that is equal to how many numbers are there? How many numbers in this? 8 small drop. That means 8 to the power 2 by 3 into what is potential of small drop? Is it given? Is it given? Huh? No. Okay. Here what is, okay. It is not required because here they have asked ratio, just a ratio, right? You have to calculate ratio. So V big divided by V small. So what do you get? 8 to the power 2 by 3. What is the answer? Yeah? Yes? Say, this is shortcut formula. This shortcut formula you have to remember. Yes, 4 is to 1. 4 is to 1. Correct. All right. Okay. So 4 is to 1. So remember this. Okay. Very, very important. Similarly, this is actually for potential I go give, right? Similarly, you can write it for capacitance also. Capacitance also. Okay. We have one more formula somewhere. Say this I gave in synopsis, but that is in synopsis, I gave it as air. Okay. So in between the plates, there is air. So if some dielectric medium is inserted, then this force is inversely proportional to K. That force is inversely proportional to K. So you can choose the answer from this. So what do you get? Force of attraction between the plates. Q square. What is the answer? Anyone? Just go through the synopsis. Option A, correct. Okay. So without dielectric medium, you have to consider only this much. Okay, without dielectric medium, you have to consider only this much. But with the dielectric medium, you have to consider K also. Okay, yeah. This you can do. Okay, Cm divided by C naught, that is equal to K. 110, that is how much? Cm, that is 110 in capacitance with the medium and capacitance with air. Okay, ratio of that two. 50. So what do you get? 2.2 you will get. Direct. Very simple problem. Okay. Ratio. This one. See. This one what I said. C is capacitance. Okay. Capacitance. So when smaller drops combine to form a bigger drop, then capacitance of bigger drop can be given like this. Capacitance of bigger drop that is equal to n to the power 1 by 3 capacitance of smaller drop. Use this equation. Use this equation. Okay. So what do you get here? What is capacitance of bigger drop? A spherical drop. It is broken. Okay. Not combined. Okay. Broken. Reverse. Okay. So equation is same. So a bigger drop is broken. So bigger drop has capacitance 1 microfarad. How many drops you get? 8, again 8 drops. So 8 to the power 1 by 3 into Cs. So you have to calculate Cs. Yes, just calculate. 8 to the power 1 by 3 means how much? That is 1 by 2, right? So 1 equal to, you will get 2, right? 2 here. 2 into Cs. So what is required? Cs is nothing but 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Microfarad, correct? No? Yes? Got it? Okay? Yes. What about this? Last one. What about this? Which option? B. Last one. Just go through the synopsis, you will get. Okay. Don't be get confused. Just go through the vector. Okay. So I'm getting all the options A, B, C, and D. Very simple concept, this one. Please go through that. General formula. Even now, mixed answers. D, D. Oh, maximum, most of you are saying it as D. Okay. Yes, D, D. Okay, just go through that. Let us see. It is given in synopsis. Okay, so I will wind up this concept here. Okay. Can I? Is it clear? Okay, two or three questions left in that. Okay, up to 50 questions we have solved now. Okay. Yes, so let us move on to current electricity. Current electricity. Okay. Yes, so let us move on to current electricity now. Yes, okay. So current, so what do you mean by current? What do you mean by current? You studied about charge, right? You studied about charge. So using that charge, or you define charge, okay. Yeah, Q by T, yes. Flow of charges, okay. Rate of flow of charges, okay. Then, still we are, okay, okay, 1 minute, 1 minute. 1 minute. I'll share that screen. Yeah. Now is it visible? Now whether it is visible? Okay. Yes. Yeah. Okay. So current electricity. Okay. Now, yes, as you said, rate of flow of charges, electric charge, that is nothing but electric current, right? So you have I equal to Q by T, right? I equal to Q by T. So through a given cross-sectional area, how much charges flow per second, that is known as electric current. Then unit of electric current, charge coulomb by time second, coulomb per second, or yes, very simple, ampere, right? Ampere. Okay, now if you want to write, consider I, you can write it in one more way. How? Dq by dt, right? Correct? No, correct? No, yes. Okay, so I q by t or dq by dt. Now, from this, if you want to calculate Q, what is the method? If you know expression for example, you get one equation, I equal to 2T square plus 3T. Okay. Now, what is the charge Q when T equal to 2 seconds? They will ask like this. They may ask questions like this. Then what do you have to do? Yes, very good. Very good, Manvit. So, what do you have to do? Integrate this. Okay. So, you have to integrate. Okay, integration from 0 to t, whatever the value of t is given, up to that you have to integrate I into dt. Correct? Yes? So if you know I expression for I, you can calculate charge. Correct now? Yes? Okay. Now, just imagine a charge is moving in a circular path. Okay. A charge is moving in a circular path. Let's consider a center here. And charge is moving in a circular path like this with certain frequency f. Okay, that means in 1 second that moves with a frequency. So number of oscillation per second, that is frequency, right? Let it be r, radius be r. A charge here q, let us consider that as q. It moves along circular path with a speed v, and the frequency of revolution is f. Then how to calculate I? I equal any a v. It is not like that. We had to reach that concept. Very simple, yeah. E into F, yes. Okay, so I is nothing but what? I is nothing but Q by T, right? I is Q by T. So 1 by T, you can write it as Q into 1 by T. So what is 1 by T? 1 by T is reciprocal of time period. Reciprocal of time period is frequency. So you can write it as Q into F. Okay, Q into F. Okay, like this you can write. Or in terms of speed. In terms of speed also you can write how? I equal to Q by T. You know, speed is nothing but distance by time, right? Correct? Yes or no? Yeah. 2 pi r is distance. That means circumference. Distance traveled in one cycle. That is circumference. So 2 pi r distance, 2 pi r by time. That gives us speed. So from this, how you can rearrange for t, no? So what you get from this, if you rearrange for t, what you get? T equal to 2 pi r by v. 2 pi r by v. Yes? Correct? So substitute that here. So q divided by 2 pi r by v. Take this to numerator. So what you get? I equal to q into v by 2 pi r. Yes? Got it? Got it or not? Yes? Yes. Okay. So that is about electric current. Now, electric current per unit area, what we call it as? Electric current per unit area. Current density. Very good. Good. So current density, what is the notation used for that? I will use my J. Okay, yes, J. That is nothing but I by A. So I is in ampere and this is in meter square. Current density, right? Ampere per meter square. So that is about current density. Okay, electric current flowing per unit area. Next, one more concept in that is very, very important concept, drift velocity. Drift velocity. So what is this drift velocity? It is the average velocity with which electrons in a conductor start drifting with the influence of external electric field, right? With the influence of external electric field, the electron starts drifting. Okay, so that is known as drift velocity. So what is the expression for that? Anyone? Vd, that is equal to Ee by m into tau. Okay, you must know the values of E. E means charge of electron, you know. E is external electric field, right? M is mass, right? What is this tau? Tau is relaxation time, right? So what do you mean by relaxation time? Yes, mean relaxation time. So what do you mean by relaxation time? Time interval between two successive collisions. Okay, time interval between two successive collisions. Okay, so when this electron move here and there, then what happens? There will be collision between the molecules of that material, right? Or between another particle. So So relax, the time interval between the successive, any two successive collisions, that is known as relaxation time. Okay, average time between successive collision. Yes, very good. Now come to that equation. What you said, relation between current and drift velocity. Relation between current and drift velocity. What is that? I equal to NA VD E. Correct? Yes. How to remember this? ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಹೇಗೆ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಇದನ್ನ ನಾವೇ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು. ಹೇಗೆ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಇದನ್ನ ನಾವೇ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು. ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕು? ನಾವೇ. ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಅದೇ ಅಲ್ಲ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಓದಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಎನ್ ಎ ನಾ ವಿಇ ವೇ ನಾ ವೇ. ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ನೆನ್ಪಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಓಕೆ, ಹಾ, ಆತರ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹಾ ಸೂಪರ್ ಅಂತದ್ದು ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ. ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇರೆ ಏನೆಲ್ಲ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡೋದಲ್ಲ, ನಿಮ್ದೇ ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಗಳನ್ನ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವೇ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ನಾವೇ. ಹಾ, ಆಯ್ತಲ್ಲಿ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಬಂತಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲೋ, ಎನ್ ಎ ವಿಇ, ಸೊ ನಾವೇ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಲೋ, ಉಳಿದದಲ್ಲಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಎನ್ ಹೇಳಿರೇನು? ಎನ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ನಂಬರ್ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ. ನಂಬರ್ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ನಂಬರ್ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ? ಯಾ, ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಯಾ, ನಂಬರ್ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರಿಲೇಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡ್ರಿಫ್ಟ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡ್ರಿಫ್ಟ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಏನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳಲ್ಲಿ? ಮೊಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ನೆನಪಿದೆಯಾ? ಮೊಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಮ್ಯೂ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ, ಡ್ರಿಫ್ಟ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಪರ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್, ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಮೊಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಡ್ರಿಫ್ಟ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ, ಸಾರಿ, ಮೊಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಮ್ಯೂ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಡ್ರಿಫ್ಟ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಪರ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್, ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಮೊಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಶುವಲಿ ಕೇಳುವಂತದ್ದು, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಆದ್ರೂ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ತರದ ಒಂದು ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ. ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ? ಮೀಟರ್ ಪರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್? ನ್ಯೂಟನ್ ಪರ್ ಕೂಲಂ. ಸೊ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು? ಮೀಟರ್ ಪರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪರ್ ನ್ಯೂಟನ್ ಕೂಲಂ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಸರಿಯಾ? ಹೆಸರ್ನು ಸರಿಯಾ? ಹಾ, ಎಸ್, ಹಾ. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ನಾವು. ಹೇಗೆ? ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಹೇಳಿದೇವಲ್ಲ, ವೋಲ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ ಮೀಟರ್ ಅಲೋ, ವೋಲ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ ಮೀಟರ್. ಎಸ್, ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್. ಹೌ? ಮೀಟರ್ ಪರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ವೋಲ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ ಮೀಟರ್. ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟು ನ್ಯೂಮರೇಟರ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಮೀಟರ್ ಮೀಟರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಮೀಟರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪರ್ ವೋಲ್ಟ್. ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ? ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ? ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ? ಓಕೆ, ಎಸ್. ದೆನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಅವರ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್? ಅಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫರ್ಡ್, ಆಲ್ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಯು ನೋ, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ಲೆಂತ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ಏರಿಯಾ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್. ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್, ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕಂಬೈನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ L by A. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು L by A. ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ರಿಮೂವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಾಲಿಟಿ ಸಿಂಬಲ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಬೈ ಎ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ರೋ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೋ ಈಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಲೂ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನ. ಓಕೆ, ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಈ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುದು ಯಾವ್ದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ? ಆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್? ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ, ಆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ it depends whether it whether yeah it depends on nature of material, right? Whether it depends on L, whether it depends on A, whether it depends on L, yes, never. Okay, it is independent of length and independent of area. So if you want to define resistivity, this resistivity, if L equal to 1 meter and area of cross section of the wire equal to 1 meter square, then you will get R equal to rho. Substitute here, L equal to 1, you substitute A equal to 1, what do you get? R equal to rho. So resistivity is resistance offered by a material of wire of unit length and unit area of cross section. So it is independent of length or area. It depends only on nature of the material. Okay, material mele depend agutte, uladadra mele depend agudilla, nenpittukolli. Okay, what about its unit? Unit eno ohm meter. Okay, ohm meter. Yes, so that is about resistivity. So next nodi ee resistance ide alla. Okay, resistivity ge innu eradu expression annu baribodu neevu. So resistivity rho can be written as m divided by N e square tau. Please remember, this is equation, very important. Now, whatever reciprocal of resistivity, what do we call it as? Reciprocal of resistivity, and then it will now conductivity, right? So 1 by rho, that is can be represented as sigma. That is nothing but conductivity. Alwa, conductivity in the other way. So what you can write from this? So rho, you know, so reciprocal of that. So sigma is nothing but N e square tau divided by m. Okay, N e square tau divided by m. Then what about its unit? Conductivity unit, you know, per ohm per meter, right? Per ohm per meter. Atho per ohm anna en helteve now? Per ohm anna en helteve? Mo, atho sim anna anta helteve, alo? So mo. Ohm anna reverse madre mo. Yes, very good. Okay, so that is about conductivity and resistivity. Okay, now please remember this R anna neevu bere bere reethiyalli baribodu makkale. In terms of volume baribodu, in terms of density baribodu, in terms of area baribodu, in terms of length baribodu. Okay, so nimge kotta question alli yavella data kottidare anta first adanna nodkolli. Depending on that you can choose the equation. Okay, so for example ivaga na simple aagi barithe nodi, R equal to rho L by A. This is the equation, you know. So length mat area kotre neevu ee tara baribodu. Okay, illa antare for example naniga idakke mele mat kelagade L inda multiply martene, just multiply and divided by L. So what you get? Rho L square divided by A L anta baribodu. Yes, so what is A into L? Area into length. Area into length is volume, so you can write it as rho L square by V in the baribodu nodi. Sariya, rho L square divided by V in the baribodu. Athava nan idanna barithe neevu just rearrange maadi northa hogi, you can write R equal to just multiply by A. Nodi idakke mele mattu kelage A inda multiply maadi, multiply by A, what do you get? Multiply by A, rho L A divided by A into A, A square hige baribodu ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ಇದೇನಾಯ್ತು, ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಯ್ತು. ಸೊ ರೋ ವಿ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಬೈ ಎ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ನೋಡಿ, ಇದು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಇಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಸಿಕ್ತು ನಮಗೆ, ರೈಟ್? ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇಕ್ವೇಶನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಎಲ್ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ, ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಸ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ಬೇಕಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನು ಬರಿಬಹುದು. ಹೇಗೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ? ಆರ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ರೋ ಎಂ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಬೈ A square D ಅಂತಲೂ ಬರಿಬಹುದು. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೀವು ರಿಯರೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಿ, ನಿಮಗೆ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಿಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಬೇಕು ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಬೈ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಎ ಇಂಟು ಎಲ್, ಅದನ್ನು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಈ ತರ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇಕ್ವೇಶನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್, ಆರ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ರೋ ಎಲ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಡಿ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಎಂ. ನೋಡಿ, ಮಾಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ಹೇಗೆ ಬರೆಯೋದು ನೋಡಿ, ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಓಕೆ ನೀವೇ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತಾ ನೋಡಿ ಆಲ್ ಆರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಎಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಎಸ್ ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಇವಾಗ ನೋಡಿ If two wires having lengths L1 and L2 and area of cross section A1 and A2 respectively are made up of same material, avattu nenpidkolli same material means density is same. Correct? No. If two wires are made up of same material means density is same. Okay. Or resistivity is same anta helabodu. Density same agutte, resistivity kuda same. ಅಲ್ವ ಆ ಸೇಮ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಈಗ ನಮಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟ ವೈರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಎಸ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಓಕೆ ಅದನ್ನ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇಕಾದ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಬೇಕಾದ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಸೊ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೋಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಟೂ ವೈರ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಲೆಂತ್ಸ್ L1 ಅಂಡ್ L2 are of cross section A1 and A2 respectively of same material of same material then this R1 by R2 is equal to L1 by L2 into A2 by A1 you can write like this or you know A is nothing but pi R square right so A proportional to R square anta baribodu hagire enaitido L1 by L2 R2 by R1 whole square okay this is for same material for different material resistivity how to consider okay for different material resistivity how to consider different material if you consider it for different material then R1 by R2 that is equal to ρ1 by ρ2 into L1 by L2 into A2 by A1 okay So like this. Again, this one also you can write. How ρ1 by ρ2, L1 by L2, R2 by R1 whole square. Okay, this is for different materials and this is for same material. Is it clear? Is it clear? Okay, for same material and different materials. Yes. Next, if in the problem if they give length and mass okay relation between r l and mass okay this is mass length and this is resistance please remember if material is same okay same material then r is proportional to l square by m very very important r is proportional to l square by m so we can write r1 by r2 that is equal to l1 by l2 whole square into m2 by m1 m2 by m1 okay Now, next one more. If two wires are made up of same material, okay, same material have equal masses. Okay, if two wires made up of same material, and have equal masses when they are stretched. Please note down this. If two wires made up of same material okay have equal masses, and these wires are stretched. In such case, this R will be proportional to L square divided by 4. Okay. During stretching, yavadaru ondu wire ni nodi nanella idanna point by point kodta idene makle nimge question odida kudle yava equation anta tappagu thagobek nimge. Okay, so question odida kudle answer maadi agbeka aa tara nanu onnande point anna kodta idene correct aagi note maadkolli idanna. Okay, so ivaga mass mattu length kottidare wire anna stretch maadidare helidre direct aagi ide equation. Okay, r proportional l square divided by r to the power 4. Hagire r1 by r2, how you can write r1 by r2 is l1 by l2 whole square r2 by r1 to the power 4. Shortcut formulas, all are shortcut formulas, please remember this. Okay, yes, one more I will give. If a wire is stretched to n times its original length, very simple. See, if you have a wire of 1 meter, okay, you have a wire of 1 meter. I need to stretch that to 2 meter. Here rest aito puna double aito hello athwa nanage 4 meter maadbeku here en aito 3 times stretched, 4 times stretched, aa tara idre n times stretch maadidre resistance hege vary agutte. So adakke one shortcut formula kodthe nodi. If a wire stretched to n times the original length, n times the original length, then resistance that will be given as n square r. Simple problem odida kulle gothagutte hige kottirtare a wire is stretched to double of its length anta. Double means what is the value of n? Double means what is the value of n? 2 square. Then what happens to resistance? 4 times r. Yes, 4 times r, correct? No, yes, 4 times r. Artha aagta idya? So direct aagi equation alli hakidre aitu, neevu adanna puna calculation maadikondu kutkolodu beda. Okay, direct aagi innond kodtene nodi, innond equation kodtene. Okay, when wire is stretched to increase its length by x percent, very simple. ಈಗ ಎಷ್ಟು ಎಷ್ಟು ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ವೈರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಚ್ಡ್ ಟು ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಬೈ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು, 2% ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಲೆಂತ್, 3% ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು, ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. Then R increases by 2x percent. Okay, on the wire, for example, wire anna 2, you know, double the length increase maadidre ankolli 2% increase aitu wire id length 2% increase aitu makale. Okay, wire the length 2% increase aitu hagiradre resistance enagutte ante ಲೆಂತ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆದ ಹಾಗೆ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗಬೇಕು ಅಲೋ, ಹಾಗೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ 2% ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆದ್ರೆ 2 × 2 4%, ಸೊ 4% ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಇದು ಇವಾಗ 2% ಆದ್ರೆ ಇದು 4% ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿರ ಸಾಕು ಮಕ್ಕಳ, ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಓದಿದ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ಆದ್ರೆ 2x%. ಓಕೆ, ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ? ಎಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಏನೋ variation of r anta it. Okay, so can I continue up to 45? 11:45 are I continue maduda? Okay, yes. Okay, after that I will give 5 minutes break. Okay, yes. So let us complete ohm's law concept onna complete maadi bro. So ohm's law. So what about this? V is equal to I into R. Hello? V equal to I R. So if you draw the graph, V and I, you must get a straight line. Right? You must get a straight line. So the devices which obey this Ohm's law are known as ohmic devices. And non-ohmic, what, can you give an example for non-ohmic device? Non-ohmic device? Semiconductor, right? Semiconductor. So you will get graph like this. For semiconductor, you'll get graph like this. Sorry. Yeah. You'll get a graph like this. Forward bias and reverse bias. Correct, no? Yes. Now, I have one question here. This is V. This is I. This is temperature T1. And this is the graph for temperature T2. Now, can you tell me in which case resistance is more? In the case of R1 or in the case of T1 or T2? For the first one or second one? Which has larger R value? Say, as T increases, R increases. Correct, no? As T increases, R increases. Correct, no? So here they will give this graph and ask you to calculate relation between resistances, or they may ask you to calculate relation between temperatures also. Okay, temperature also. So in this case, T1 will be greater than T2. Okay, T1 will be greater than T2 and R1 will be greater than R2. So how to get R1 and R2 value from this? Just taking slope value, correct? Slope value. So slope value gives delta V divided by delta I. So if R is more, if slope value is more, then temperature is more because they are directly proportional. Correct? This type of questions are very important. Please note down that. Okay. Yes. Then Ohm's law in vector form, you know, right? What is that? J equal to sigma into E, vector form. Okay. Yes. Then next, at a different temperature, if you want to calculate resistance value, for example, resistance at some temperature R2. At T2 and T1. At T1, resistance is R1, and at T2, resistance is R2. Now, if you want to calculate R2, then we can write R1 into 1 plus alpha T2 minus T1, or T2 minus T1 can be written as delta T also. Delta T also. Okay. So, what is alpha? Alpha is, what is alpha? Coefficient of resistivity. Temperature coefficient, okay? Temperature coefficient of resistance, you can say. So if you consider rho here, temperature coefficient of resistivity, okay? So that is about alpha, okay? Say this alloys, some materials, manganin, constantin, these are all having low temperature coefficient of resistivity. That means even though temperature changes, its resistivity value won't change. Okay, its resistivity value won't change. T1 is less than T2. T1 is greater than T2. Please go through this. T1 is greater than T2. If it is interchange, T1 is less than T2, then R2 is greater than R1. Like that. Just interchange that. Okay, Tejas. Teja. Okay. Okay, that this is about resistance values. Okay. Now, one more I will tell you about combination of resistors. In the case of combination of resistors, if you have a wire and if you cut that wire and if you join them in parallel, if you have a large wire, okay, you have a large wire and you need to cut it to n pieces and connect all those n pieces in parallel, then what about effective resistance? Okay, for that I will give one shortcut formula. If a wire of resistance R cut into n equal parts n equal parts and then connected in parallel. Then connected in parallel. Then the resistance value. If you cut it and connect them in parallel, you won't get same resistance value as before. Okay, same as resistance value as before. So R dash is given by R by N square. R by N square. For example, if you have a wire of length L, okay, and its resistance is R. If you cut this into two parts, then what happens? Length is resistance is directly proportional to length. So what do you get? So a wire of length R by 2 and another wire of length R by 2. Now connect these two in parallel. Now what about its effective resistance? What do you get? Tell me how these are connected. R by 4, right? So this can be calculated using this equation. How? Just substitute the value of N. How many parts? Two parts. So just substitute 2 here. So what do you get? R by 2 square is nothing but R by 4. Got it right? Simple. Yes? Got it or not? Yes. Okay. So for one or two or three parts directly you can solve like this. But if there are n large number of parts, for example, they will say 14 parts, 15 parts, like that. Then what you have to do? Just substitute in this equation directly you can get. Okay? Yes, then let us have 5 minutes break now. 5 minute break. Okay, within 5 minutes, I will come back. Okay, yes. Okay, so shortcut tricks are so many shortcut tricks are there, but the thing is, our class lengthy akta ide aste. Okay, trick gal tumba ide shortcut galu, but class lengthy akta ide. Irle, bega, start maado. ನೋಡಿ ಇವತ್ತಿನ ಸಿನಾಪ್ಸಿಸ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಸಿನಾಪ್ಸಿಸ್ ಓದಿ ನೀವೇ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು. ಫುಲ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ನೀರು ಕುಡ್ದಾಗಿ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು ಆ ಥರ. ಓಕೆ, ಫುಲ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ಕಟ್ಗಳು. ಹಾಂ, ಯಾರೋ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಅಂತಲ್ವಾ, ಸಮನ್ ಆಸ್. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್? ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್, ದಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ ನಿಮಗೆ. ಓಕೆ, they may ask you to compare the temperatures. Okay, so from that, how to get the how to compare this temperature, whether T1 is greater than T2 or T1 less than T2, hey, compare madodu. Slope nodi, slope jaasti ide ante helidre adakke resistance jaasti irutte. Slope jaasti ide ante helidre adakke resistance jaasti irutte makkale. Howda, resistance jaasti ide ante helidre adakke temperature enagirbeku heli. ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಏನಾಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು? ಹೈಯರ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಸ್ಲೋಪ್ ಆನ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಎಟ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಲೋಪ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ದಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಟು, ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಒನ್, ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ನೋ, ರೈಟ್? ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದೆನ್ ಆರ್ ಲೆಸ್ ದೆನ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಸನ್, ದೆನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್. ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಓಕೆ, T1 ಅನ್ನೇ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಲ್ಲ ಅವರು, ಹಾಗೆ ಕೇಳಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಸನ್ ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ಆರ್ ಲೆಸ್ಸರ್, ಆ ತರ ಕೇಳಬಹುದು. ಓಕೆ, ಎಸ್, ಸಮನ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ದಟ್. ಯಾರು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ನನಗೆ, ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಗಾಟ್ ದಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಎಸ್, ಓಕೆ. ನೌ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ನೋ, series and parallel combination. Okay, series combination of resistors, right? ನೋಡಿ, ಈ ಸಲ ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಬರಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ಕೊಳ್ತೇನೆ ನಾನು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನಿಮಗೆ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇನು ಕೇಳಲ್ಲ, ಬಂದ್ರೂ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ನಿಮಗೆ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ದೀರಿ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್, ಅದೇ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಕೊಡೋದು ಒಳ್ಳೇದು, ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಮೇಲೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಬೇಕು, ಬಟ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಅಷ್ಟೇನು ಕೇಳಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ ನೋಡುವ. ಸೊ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸೀರೀಸ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್? ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ, ರೈಟ್? ಹಾ, ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸೀರೀಸ್, ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎನ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್. ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ನೋ? ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ? ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್, ಎನ್ ಆರ್ 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 ಎನ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್, ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಆರ್ ಪಿ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ, ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಬರಿತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ, ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಪಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಟೂ, ಎನಿ ಹೌ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಎನ್ ನಂಬರ್, ಎನ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಎನ್ ನಂಬರ್ಗೆ ಆರ್ ಬೈ ಎನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆರ್ ಬೈ ಎನ್, ಎಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ವಿಚ್ ರಿಮೈನ್ಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್? ವಿ ಸೇಮ್, ರೈಟ್? ವಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಮ್? ಐ ಸೇಮ್, ರೈಟ್? ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್, ಎಸ್. ಯಾ, ಡಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ ಕಾರಣ, ಆದ ಕಾರಣ ನಾನು ಅದನ್ನು ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೇಳಿಕ್ ಹೋಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ನೀವು ಓದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಅದು. ಓಕೆ, ಓದನ್ನ ನಿಲ್ಬೇಡಿ ಮಂಜುನಾಥ್, ಮಂಜು. ಓಕೆ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಓದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಅದನ್ನ, ಡಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮೇಲಿಂದ ಮೇಲೊಂದು ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡೋದು ಬೇಡ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಎಸ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ಸೆಲ್ಸ್, ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಹೋಗುವ. ಓಕೆ, ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೊಂದಿದೆ, ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್. ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್, ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ವೆರಿ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಕಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ, ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಕಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ, ಈ ತರ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ಇದೆ ಅನ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಥ್ರೂ ದಿಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಐ ಫ್ಲೋಸ್, ಸಮ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಐ ಫ್ಲೋಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಒನ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಅರಾಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್, ಐ ಟೂ ಗೋಸ್ ಅರಾಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಐ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಐ ಟೂ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಐ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಐ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಐ ಟೂ ಇನ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿ ಆರ್ ಒನ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿ ಆರ್ ಟೂ. ನಾವ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಐ ಒನ್, ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಕಟ್, ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಕಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಐ ಒನ್, ಏನ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್? ಹಾ, ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್, ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್? ಐ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಟೋಟಲ್, ನಾನು ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಬರೀಲ. ಓಕೆ, ಹಾ, ಐ ಒನ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಇಂಟು ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅದರ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಐ ಟೂ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಿರೋ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ, ಟೋಟಲ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅದರ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್, ಐ ಟೂ ಹೋಗುವ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಐ ಟೂ ಈ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಸೊ ಅದರ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಇದು, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅದರ್ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಬೈ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್. ಇದು ಎರಡು ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನ. ಓಕೆ, ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ, ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಓಕೆ? ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್? ಸೆಲ್ಸ್, ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೆಲ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಪಂಪ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆದಾಗೆ, ನೀವು ಹೇಗೆ ನೀರನ್ನ ಪಂಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪಂಪ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ, ಒಂದ್ ಕಡೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ ಕಡೆ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪಂಪ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ, ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಅನ್ನ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡುವಂತದ್ದು ಸೆಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಒಂದು ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಬಿಲ್ಡ್ಅಪ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಯಾಕೆ, ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಿದ್ರೆ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ, ಸೇಮ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆದ್ರೆ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಜೀರೋ ಅಂತಾರೆ, ನೋ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಫ್ಲೋಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಲೋವರ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್, ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಎ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಾಟ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಡನ್ ಬೈ ಸೆಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೆಲ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮೇಂಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎಸ್. ಸೊ ಎ ಸೆಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್, ಅದನ್ನ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ ನಾವು? ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್, ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಸೆಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಫ್ಲೋ ಆಫ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ನಾವು ಈ ತರ ಬರಿತೇವೆ, ಇ ಎಂ ಎಫ್ ಇ ಅಂತ ಬರಿತೇವೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಆಕ್ಚುಯಲ್ ಹೇಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಸೆಲ್ ಇನ್ ಸಿಂಬಲ್, ಎ ಸೆಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಸಮ್ internal resistance ether irbeku cell id symbol okay emf maximum potential difference e and internal resistance r but generally we use this one because this r is very 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 small internal resistance is very small therefore we neglect it okay yes so now in on the term idalli terminal potential difference okay terminal potential difference that is represented as v that means if in a cell if there is no current flowing okay current flow aagta illa ee tara ide positive terminal negative terminal ante ee tara ide so ivaga you across this point and across this point if you measure the potential difference then that is known as terminal potential difference okay when no current flows okay potential difference across the terminals of the cell when no current flows hoda just athwa adu emf annu define martave now next irli so simple aagi ee tara nenpidkolli ishte saaku potential difference across the terminals of the cell ant ankolli potential difference across the terminals of the cell that is terminal potential difference okay so next emf ge baruva emf electromotive force okay so to define this let us consider some external circuit nanu adashtu minimum aagi helike try martene okay so there is a cell this is internal resistance okay r so illinda illi tanaka idu cell ankolli let it be cell okay emf of this cell is e so current flows like this okay now whatever energy supplied out of that yeah work done in moving a unit charge once around the circle that is known as electromotive force yes very good okay satvik so work done in moving a unit charge once around the circuit so one unit charge anna illinda hidkondo one round barbek ille hogi 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 one picnic hogi hige hogi 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 puna illige barbek ashta aglike estu work aitu yar work madodalli work done by the cell hello work done by the cell of cell estu work madutte one unit charge anna one round hodislike one trip karkondo hogi barlike estu work madutte ant helodanna now emf ant helutave okay सो इवली जस्ट ईर एक्सापल हेते अपन गिस अपन थाउजेंड रुपीस को अंदी ओके थाउजेंड रुपीसली पिक्चर होगी अथवा मालिग होगी अल ईनूर रूपाय खर्च माती ओके ईनूर रूपाय खर्च माती ओके नेक्स्ट इन उल्तर इन स्वल्प हण उत अलो आ हणव इन कड़े हम खर्च माती ओके हाँ अलग हण खाली आते निम्बल ओके अप को हण कंप्लीट आगे एर कड़े खाली हाद ना इन अप को हण एप्सिलॉन अंत अप को हण ओके अदर ईनूर रूपये इले खर्च मे सो इन ईनूर रूपये इले खर्च अंदी ओके ईनूर रूपये इले कड़ी आगते खर्च या स्मॉल रेसिस्टेंस बट ना एक्सापल अल्वा टोटल हण अंतल the amount you spent here plus that amount you spent here correct allo yes so we can write the total amount I will write here namige iga concept ig barwa here potential drop is v okay and here potential drop is v dash and ankolu here potential drop is v dash so total emf that is nothing but v plus v dash anta baribodu makkale yes total amount is nothing but amount spent here plus amount spent here correct allo potential drop here plus potential drop here sariya ha so e can be written as v equal to current flow potential drop across external resistance is nothing but current through that external resistance into resistance helire enaytu i into r current through that plus sorry into resistance plus v dash is across this potential drop across this there is a current through that is to i resistance is to r so e equal to i into r plus r anta baribodu makale yes v equal to i into r plus r anta baribodu now sari alwa ha so i equal to en sikthagire e divided by r plus r e divided by R plus R. This is the current. Got it? Got it? Yes or no? Yes? Yes. So, from that, see, from this, if you want to calculate terminal potential difference, V beku. E minus V dash bari boda. That is E minus, what is V dash? I R and the bari boda. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes. Okay. But please remember, very, very important concept. This is the case V equal E minus I R and the alva. Idi avaga. Idu charging case. Yard case barutale. Okay, you have to consider two cases. Okay. So during charging. Of cell and in on the during discharging charging matu discharging adaga. Okay, so charging madaga enagate charging maduaga sorry. Okay, so here we can consider two cases, one charging and another discharging. So for one, we can write V equal E minus IR and another one V equal to E plus IR. Okay, yard case gal barute makale ili, yard case barute, one do E minus IR and another one is E plus IR. Okay, E minus IR and E plus IR. So during charging matu, discharging. Is there a correct tag in order kolo beko? Yaudu charging, yaudu discharging and thirdana correct tag in note poly. Okay? Yes. Next. Ivaga, either in the internal resistance expression on the very likagatanami. Internal resistance expression on the very bodo. Hege, how to get expression for internal resistance? We have V equal IR, right? V equal IR. So I, you know, I is E divided by R plus R into R, right? So we can write V equal E minus IR. Generally, we consider this one. V equal E minus IR. E minus IR. So from this, we can write V equal to I into R. Hello? I into R. Okay. So from this, we can rearrange for R, right? Sorry. From this, 1 minute. Yeah. So from this, you can rearrange for IR, right? So what do you get? IR equal to, what do you get? IR equal to E minus V, right? So IR equal to E minus V or R, that is what I need. E minus V by I. Sorry, Allah. Yes or no? Correct? Correct? Yes? Okay. Now, here, once again, for this, you can substitute V by R. So R equal E minus V divided by V by R and the substitute mod. V by R substitute mod. That implies R equal to what? E minus V divided by V into R. Ithar bari bodu nodi. Sariya? Yes? Okay. Yes? Okay. So, if in on if in open circuit, in open circuit, yavattu V is equal to E agirthade. Okay, no current flows. Okay, no current flows. I equal to zero. Okay, when the circuit is open, when the circuit is open, terminal potential difference is be equal to what? EMF of the cell. When the circuit is open, please remember that. Okay, now cells in series and parallel, cells in series and parallel. Okay, So series consider madidre na diagram ella madlik hogala makle. So series E equivalent equal to E1 plus E2 and R equivalent equal to R1 plus R2, right? Correct? Yes? Correct now? Yeah. Now, so if you want to calculate current in this case, so current in external circuit, current in external circuit. Current in external circuit, how you can write? For example, N, let us consider N cells, okay? N cells of EMF E in series. N cells of EMF E in the series. Then what about E equivalent and R equivalent? Tell me. Yes, this will be N times E. What about R equivalent? What about R equivalent? NR, yes, very good. Okay, so in that case, in this particular case, if you want to calculate current, then we can write, generally what is that I? I is equal to E divided by R plus R, right? E divided by R plus R. But here, E will be N times E, and R is external circuit resistance, and this will be NR. Correct? Sari idiya nodi? Sari makale? N cells iddaga. Yes or no? Apeksha, yes. Okay? Yes. So, that is about, you know, series combination. Okay. Illi innond kelthare makale. So, generally we connect like this, series. Right? This is general connection. Negative of one is connected to positive of another, like this, right? Like this you connect. This is in general. Now, if you connect one in reverse, what will happen? If you connect one in reverse, just look at this. These two are connected in reverse order, right? Reverse. Okay. So, if you connect one cell as reverse, then equal EMF, okay, E, all are having E, internal resistance R, okay, E, R, okay, if you connect like this, these two cells get cancelled, okay, one in on the case, in opposite I connect, if you connect one cell in reverse order, you have to neglect two cells, okay, idu mathe idu cancel aagi hogutte, so please remember, okay, so, equation and if shortcut another shortcut, okay. If M cells oppositely connected, in N cells, total number of cells is N, out of that total number of cells, M cell opposite I connect maadidre, then E equivalent can be written as N minus 2M into E. Please remember this. Okay, so pratyondu term in cell in a EMF no E atho epsilon. Okay, you can consider this as E, no problem. Okay, please remember this shortcut formula. Okay, please remember this shortcut formula. For example, 10 cells are there. Okay, 10 cells here. Okay, 10 cells, capital N equal to 10 unquali. Okay, out of that, two cells reversely connected. Now, what is the answer? Equivalent capacity, EMF. What is equivalent EMF? 6E. Yes? So, got it? Either Sariagan input called shortcut. Okay? Yes, that is about series combination, makale. Is it clear? Okay. Yes. Next up, parallel combination. Okay. Parallel combination. So E enagutte parallel combination alli equivalent equal to E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2 agutte, and R equivalent equal to R1 plus R2 divided by, so what do you get? Sorry, R1 R2, right? R1 R2 divided by R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 agutte. Okay, so for n cells of EMF E and internal resistance R, what do you get? E equivalent equal to parallel alli avude change agalla, it is not E by N. Teja, it is not E by N. In parallel combination voltage remains same. ನೀವು ಎರಡು ಸೆಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ನಾಲ್ಕು ಸೆಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ಹತ್ತು ಸೆಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ಹಂಡ್ರೆಡ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಇ ಎಂ ಎಫ್ ಅದೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಈಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಇ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಆರ್ ಎಪ್ಸಿಲಾನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಈಕ್ವಾಲಿಂಟ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಆರ್ ಈಕ್ವಾಲಿಂಟ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಆರ್ ಬೈ ಎನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಆರ್ ಈಕ್ವಾಲಿಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಬೈ ಎನ್, ಬಟ್ ಇ ಈಕ್ವಾಲಿಂಟ್ ಅದೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, then we can write expression for current, right? Therefore, what is the expression for current? NE then agutte EA irutte. So E divided by, what is that? R plus R by N anta agutte. Or you can take LCM here. E divided by NR plus R by N varibodu makkale, ee tara varibodu nodi. If you simplify, you can write NE divided by ಎನ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆರ್. ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ನೋಡಿ, ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಚೆಕ್, ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಚೆಕ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎಸ್, ಎಸ್, ಓಕೆ. ದೆನ್ ಸೊ ಒಂದು ವೇಳೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಗೆ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ರಿವರ್ಸ್, ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ತರ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ, ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಇ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇ ಟು ಆರ್ ಟು. ಓಕೆ, ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್, ದೆನ್ ಇ ಇಕ್ವಾಲೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಇ ಒನ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ಮೈನಸ್ ಇ ಟು ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಬೈ ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ಅಂತ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರೋ ಒಂದನ್ನ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? Is it clear? I think Teja, you have some doubt. Okay, you can message me personally. Okay, I will answer to that. Okay, yes. Next, power. So P equal to VI, right? Power is nothing but P equal to VI, or you can write it as I square R, or you can write it as V square by R. ನೆನ್ಪಿದೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಈಕ್ವೇಶನ್? ಎಸ್, ಎಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ಪವರ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ನೋ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪವರ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಎನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹೀಟ್, ಎಚ್ ಹೀಟ್ ಜನರೇಟೆಡ್, ಹೀಟ್ ಡಿಸಿಪೇಟೆಡ್, ಆರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಹೀಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಡಿಸಿಪೇಟೆಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಎಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು P into T, correct? No, actually H is energy. Energy means work, right? Work is nothing but energy, right? Both are having same units. So you can write that as power into time, work. So power equal to work by time. So work equal to power into time. So as I said, work can be considered as heat here, work done or heat dissipated. So P into T, that is H. Or you can write this as P can be written as VI. So VI into T, like this you can write. VI into T you can write, right? Or you can write it as I square RT. Or you can write it as V square T by R. Many equations we have, depending on the given data. Depending on given data, you can choose, select the equations. Yes or no? Correct? Yes. Okay, Next, let us move on to KCL and KVL. Okay, KCL and KVL. So what is KCL? At the junction. Okay, at the junction. Okay. Gurudat, you can message me personally. Okay. So KCL and KVL. Okay. Yes. So KCL. Yes. What is KCL? Yes. Kirchhoff current law, Kirchhoff current law and Kirchhoff voltage law. Right? So what about its statement? What about that statement? KCL. So at the junction, current entering the junction that is equal to current leaving that junction, correct? I1, I2, I3, I4. So apply KCL for this junction rule. So what happens? Current entering I1 plus I2 is the current entering, right? So what is current leaving? I3 and I4 are the current leaving. Therefore, I1 plus I2 minus I3 minus I4 will be equal to zero. Correct? Correct? Sum of current entering is equal to sum of current leaving that node. Right? Therefore, at the junction, what is the current? At the junction, what is the current? At the junction, what is the current? Zero. 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 So you can touch that junction. At the junction, current zero. Physics sir told us about this in detail. So when, if you consider a junction in a circuit, current entering is equal to current leaving. So at the junction, no current. Therefore, you can touch that point. Correct? No, nothing will happen. Current is zero, right? Current is zero, right? What will happen? What will happen? Yes? At the junction, current is zero. How shock? Current is zero, right? Yeah. It doesn't mean that at the junction, current is zero. The whatever current is entering, same amount of current is leaving. Okay. For example, in this case, say, don't touch that point. Okay. So in this particular point, if you go and touch this junction, then what happens? This current gets one more path to flow. Right? So what happens? It gets one more path to flow. Right? So now this equation becomes plus I5 and this becomes minus I5. Correct now? Okay, so our body is a good conductor. Don't do this experiment in your home or somewhere else. Okay, is it clear? So current at that junction is zero means what? Current entering is equal to current leaving. Okay, whatever current is entering that junction, same amount of current leaves from there. Correct now? Yes. Yes. So that is about KCL. Let us move on to KVL. KCL. Say, now can you tell me, you will get, say, in this particular case, you may get some questions like this. 1 ampere, 2 ampere. Okay. 3 ampere. What is the value of I? What is the value of I? Yes, conservation of charge. Yes, correct. Based on conservation of charge. Right. Madhukar. Yes, it is 6 ampere. Right? It is 6 ampere. So you can consider this as a junction. Even though circuit is like this, it is just like this. Okay, this is I. This is 3 ampere. This is 1 ampere. and this one is 2 ampere. Just ee tara madabodu makkale neevu idiga illi nimge square kottirtare athava nimge circle e kodli yene kodli adanna en maadi neevu ondu junction anta assume maadi aste adu nimge confuse maadlikoskara ee tara kottirtare athava illi yavudaru ondu current value nu kottirabodu okay so idannella nodlikke hogbedi neevu idanna junction anta imagine maadi ondu dot haaki aga nimge clear aagi ee answer eshtu anta sigutte right 6 ampere artha aagta idya yes athava ee tara kodabodu बेरे बेरे रीतल को ब्रांच ओके टू एम्पियर थ्री एम्पियर एंटरिंग ओके सो वन एम्पियर सो पड़ी दिस अंत पड़ी आंसर फोर यस यस Correct, Alva. So I think you got the an idea regarding this KCL. Okay. Next, KVL. KVL, you want to circuit talk about now? Okay. A simple circuit draw, Martha. R1, R2, EMF. Okay. Current flows along this. So A, B, C, D. Apply here. KVL apply, Madi. A to B other resistor is there no resistor right so A to B no resistance leave it so in the direction of current flow what do you have to consider so in the direction of current negative okay in the direction of current negative opposite to the direction of current positive agutte okay in the direction negative agutte then ಇದೇಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ನೋಡಿ ಈ ತರ ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಓಕೆ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಅದಲ್ಲ ತುಂಬಾ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗೋದಿದ್ರೆ ಈ ತರ ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಸೈನ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಓಕೆ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಸೋ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಸೈನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಟರ್ಮಿನಲ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಸೈನ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಓಕೆ ನೋ Come to this. Now apply KVL here for this one. What happens? Minus IR2, right? Next, illindi illigideya. Illa. Next, enaagtade illi. So yava directionally hogta ide? Current in the directionally hogta idira. Hello. Minus I into R1. Next here, negative to positive. What do you have to consider? Negative to positive. Positive. Hello. Towards positive terminal you are moving. Therefore, positive. Therefore. Plus E that is equal to zero. Artha aagta idya? So like this you can apply KVL. Is it clear? Okay. Yes. So in the direction of current positive. Sorry. You know, in the direction negative and opposite to the direction positive. Okay. Yes. So as per NCERT sign convention you have to apply. Okay. So in previous state syllabus and all, on the kelo varsha modlu reverse itto. In the direction positive itto opposite to the direction negative antalla itto but ivaga now apply madodu ee concept idanne apply maadi okay
yes
I think ivattu synopsis aagi bidutade makkale nodwa synopsis on clear maadkolli current electricity thumba important chapter idu okay so salpa time jaasti tagondru tondre now next innond chapter alli adjust maadwa okay magnetism matter salpa smaller chapter ide alli nan time adjust maartene idanna okay but idu clear maadkolli concept galu clear maadkolli ओके वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ओके ना अस्टे शॉर्टकट नो फार्मुला लिस्ट आउट आ पीडीएफ बंद मेले तेज नोवे फार्मुला लिस्ट मकले ओके नानबिड़ते नोल आगे बिड़ते फार्मुला इंपॉर्टेंट एग्जांपल हेतने ओके सो नहीं तरगति कलता निम्बेफ्ट सैडल कूतवर नेपाता योचने Who is sitting left to you when you are there in the first standard? Who is sitting left to you? Kelavaru yochana martta idare nanu yava school alli odidappa anta. Hello, aamele ondane class alli odidde yaar. Pakkadalli yaru yava classroom anta adu aamele yochana madudu. Hello, ondane class yavudu anta na odiddena illo anta kelavaru yochana martare. Igina makkalige iga manne inda aage aagide. Ella promotion aage. Yavaga anta helude nenpaagta illa. हेलो ಹೌದಾ? ಯಾವ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಥವಾ ಟೀಚರ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕೇಳ್ಬೇಕು, ಆ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನೆನಪಿಲ್ಲ ಇವಾಗ, ಹೌದಾ? ಹಾ, ಸೊ ಹಾಗೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು? ನೆನಪಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಯಾಕೆ? ಅಥವಾ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಒಂದು ಜಾತ್ರೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ರೆ, ಆ ಒಂದನೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಲ್ತವ್ರು ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅಪರೂಪಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾರೋ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಿಸ್ತದೆ? ಎಲ್ಲೋ ನೋಡಿದ ಹಾಗೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅನ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀರಿ ನೀವು ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಹಾ, ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್, ಅವ್ರು ಹೌದಾ ಇವರ, ಅವರ ಇವರ ಮಾತಾಡೋದ ಬೇಡವಾ ಅಂತ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಹಾ, ಅಕ್ಕನ ತಮ್ಮನ ಅಣ್ಣನ ಅಲ್ವಾ? ಏನು ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್, ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಏನು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ, ನೀವು ಈ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾಗಳನ್ನು ಹಾಗೆ ಡೈಲಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ನೆನಪಿರುತ್ತೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ. ಓಕೆ, ನಾನು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಏನಾಯ್ತು? ಹಾ, ಅವರ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕಣ್ಣ ಮುಂದೆ ಬಂತಾ ಇಲ್ವಾ? ಎಸ್ ಸರ್ ನೋ? ಹಾ, ಒಂದನೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನ ಫ್ರೆಂಡಿನ ಹಾಗೆ, ಒಂದನೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತವರ ಹಾಗೆ ಆಯ್ತಾ ನಿಮಗೆ? ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ ಕೂಡಲೇ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕಣ್ಣ ಮುಂದೆ ಬಂತು. ಯಾಕೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ? ಅದು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕೇಸಿಗೂ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕೇಸಿಗೂ ಏನು ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್? ಯಾಕೆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳಿ, ಟೆಲ್ ಮಿ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್. ಡೈಲಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ ನೀವು ಅಲೋ, ಡೈಲಿ ನೋಡ್ತೀರಿ ಅಲೋ, ಡೈಲಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೀರಿ, ಹಾಸ್ಟೆಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೀರಿ, ಡೈಲಿ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತೀರಿ ಅಲೋ, ಆದ ಕಾರಣ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇದೆ, ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲೋ, ಕೂಡ್ಲೆ ಬಂತು. ಸೊ ಇದೇ ರೀತಿ ನೀವು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾಗಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು? ಡೈಲಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ನೋಡಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಒಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಬುಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಡೈಲಿ ಆ ಹಲ್ಲುಜ್ಜು ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಇಲ್ಲದ್ರೆ ಹಲ್ಲುಜ್ಜು ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಹಲ್ಲುಜ್ಜುವಾಗ ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಹೀಗೆ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸಾಕು, ಪೇಜ್ ಟರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸಾಕು. ಓಕೆ, ಡೈಲಿ ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕು, ನೋಡಿದ ಪೇಜ್ ಅನ್ನೇ ಪುನಃ ಪುನಃ ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕು ಡೈಲಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಆಗೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಆ ಪೇಜ್ ಉಂಟಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಅಚ್ಚಾಗಿ ಹಾಗೆ ಉಳಿತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಇದು ತುಂಬಾ ನೋಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಸಣ್ಣದು ತಲೆ, ಓಕೆ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ತುಂಬಾ ಇದೆ. ಹಾ, ಅಷ್ಟು ಬೇಗ ಹ್ಯಾಂಗ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಅದು. ಓಕೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ವೈರಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು, ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಾರೆ ಅದು ಹ್ಯಾಂಗ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಡೈಲಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಶಾಟ್ ತೆಗೆದು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ನೋಡಿದ ಕೂಡಲೇ, ಹಾ ಕೂಡ್ಲೇ ಅದು ಸರ್ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ವೇರ್ ಅದು ವರ್ಕ್ ಇದೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ, ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ವೇರ್ ಇದೆ, ನೀವು ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅದನ್ನಷ್ಟೇ. ಓಕೆ, ನೋಡಿದ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಹಾ ಇದು ಈ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಅಂತ ನೆನಪಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಾರೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಹಾಗೆ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಲೋ. ಇದು ನ್ಯೂಮರೇಟರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರಿಬೇಕೋ ಡಿನಾಮಿನೇಟರ್, ಆ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಈ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಯಾವ್ದು ಅಂತ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಆತರ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಬರಬಾರದು, ಆತರ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಬರಬಾರದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು? ನೀವು ಡೈಲಿ ಅದರೊಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಎಸ್ ಸರ್ ನೋ? ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಏನಿಲ್ಲ, ನೀವು ನೋಡಿ ಮೈ ರೂಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಫುಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹಾಕ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಲೋ, ಹಾಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆ, ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಗೋಡೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮನ ಹತ್ರ ಪೇಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳಿ, ತೊಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಡೆ ಇದ್ದಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾಸೇ ಕಾಣ್ಬೇಕು, ನೀವು ಈಚೆ ತಿರುಗಿದ್ರು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ, ಆಚೆ ತಿರುಗಿದ್ರು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಡೆ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾಸೇ ಕಾಣ್ಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು 60 ದಿನ ಓಕೆ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾದಲ್ಲೇ ಮುಳುಗ್ಬೇಕು ನೀವು. ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಆರಾಮ್ಸೆ ನೀವು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಓದ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ, ಕೆಸಿಇಟಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಸ್ಕೋರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇನ್ನು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಏನು ಡಿರೈವೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರು ಕೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬರುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ಅದನ್ನ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಆಗುತ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ವಾ? ಎಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್. ಆ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಹಠದಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ 2 ತಿಂಗಳು ಅದೇ ಹಠದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರಿ, ನೋಟ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಏನು ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ನೋಟ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ನೀವೀಗ ನೀಟ್ಗೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ನೀಟಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಆಗೋದಿದ್ರೆ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ NCERT ಅದು ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ವರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ವರ್ಡ್ ಓದ್ಬೇಕು ನೀವು. ಓಕೆ, ನೀಟಿಗೆ ಅದನ್ನೇ ಸಾಕು, ಅದೇ ನಿಮಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ವಸ್ವದು NCERT ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವಂಥದ್ದು. ಓಕೆ, ಅದು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ನಾ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ದಿನ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ಇದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಈಗ ಇದನ್ನೊಂದು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಗೆ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಬುಕ್. ಓಕೆ, ಪ್ರತಿ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಇದು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆ, ಎಸ್, ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೀಟ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್. ಓಕೆ, ವೀಟ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್. ವೀಟ್ ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್, ಹೌದಾ? ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್? PQR, ಎಸ್. ಸೊ ಏನಾಗ್ಬೇಕು ಕಂಡೀಷನ್, ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್? P/Q = R/S. ಹಲೋ, P/Q = R/S. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ P/Q = R/S, ನೋ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲನೋಮೀಟರ್, ರೈಟ್? IG will be equal to zero, no current flows through this galvanometer. That means, P/Q = R/S ಅಂತಾದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಗ್ಯಾಲನೋಮೀಟರ್ ಇದ್ರು ಅದ್ರ ಮೂಲಕ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಹೋಗಲ್ಲ. ಹೇಳ್ರಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು 1 ohm ಹಾಕಿ, 100 ohm ಹಾಕಿ, 1000 ohm ಹಾಕಿ, ಅಥವಾ ಪುರುಷೋತ್ತರ 10,000 ohm ಹಾಕಿ, ಓಕೆ, ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಹಾಕಿದ್ರೆ ಅದ್ರ ಮೂಲಕ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಹೋಗಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ನೆಗ್ಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ದಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನ ನೆಗ್ಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಯ್ತು, इधर नेग्लेक्ट मार रहे P and Q are in series, R and S are in series, so series combination is calculation made, and here also we can calculate, right? Now these two combinations are in parallel, so that you can calculate effective resistance, right? Correct? Yes or no? Yes. Yes. So please remember that concept. Okay, Wheatstone network. And based on this, one more device works. What is that? One more device based on Wheatstone network. To it is not potentiometer. Meter bridge. Very good. Meter bridge. Right? Meter bridge. What is the use of meter bridge? What is the use of meter bridge? You can find unknown value. Hello. Unknown resistance and calculate maadlike agutte. Okay, unknown resistance. So you know the relation R by S is nothing but L divided by 1 minus L. R is unknown resistance. Correct, no? Yes. Then next, as you said, potentiometer. If you consider, what is the use of potentiometer? Potentiometer is used in makla. Yes, you can measure internal resistance, right? Internal resistance you can measure. Similarly, potential difference between any two points, potential difference across, okay? Difference between and helabardu, it is always across, potential difference across any two points in a wire, right? Then comparison of EMF of two cells, all these are the applications of potentiometer. So in the case of comparison of EMF, we can write E1 by E2 equal to L1 by L2. This is very important relation, right? And potential drop is directly proportional length. This is nothing but principle of what? Potentiometer. Okay, principle of potentiometer is potential drop across any two points in a wire is directly proportional to the length of that portion, provided condition is a unit area of cross section irbeku and same current has to flow through that. Okay, unit area of cross section iddu constant current flow aagta ide ant helidre potential drop is directly proportional to length of that portion. Adannu nenpikolle. Okay, then innond ide. ಇದೇ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಇಯರ್ ಅಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಇದು ತುಂಬಾ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಇದನ್ನು ನಾನು ನೋಡಿ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ಕಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ ಸಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಡು ಯು ನೋ ದಿಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಓಕೆ ಸಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಲಿಸನ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಸೇ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ and like this, you have two options. That means opposite poles connected together, similar poles connected together. So in this case, if you consider this as E1 and E2, EMFs as E1 and E2, okay, in this case, what is effective EMF? E1 plus E2. And in this case, it will be E1 minus E2. Let us consider E1 is greater than E2, okay? Else you have to interchange. So if you consider this in a potentiometer, if balancing length is L1, and in this case, if balancing length is L2, then you can have or you can calculate E1 and E2 value using this equation. E1 plus E2 divided by E1 minus E2, that is equal to L1 by L2. Please remember this. Okay. So in the problem they will give you when similar poles are connected together, and second one when opposite poles are connected together. They oppose each other means opposite poles are connected together, okay? And this one is similar poles are connected together. When similar poles are connected, balancing length they will provide, and when opposite poles are connected together, balancing length they will provide. Then you may need to calculate E1 or A2 or in any one of the quantity you can find out. Okay, you have to use this equation, or this can be written in one more way. E1 by E2, that is equal to L1 plus L2 divided by L1 minus L2. This is one more method. Okay, one more method. Please remember these two shortcut formulas. Okay, if you go through the previous year questions and all, they will ask this type. You will get certain questions. Okay, certain questions based on this method. Direct substitution. Basically, Madhukar, now you got it? Madhukar. Yes, okay, please remember this. And finally, internal resistance. One more formula for internal resistance. Okay. Dhanush, you can ask that later. Okay. So, internal resistance, for that, of course, I said using potentiometer, you can measure internal resistance. No. So, what is the equation for that? What is the equation? L1 minus L2 divided by L2 into R. Okay. Internal resistance. Okay. So this is about applications. Okay. Applications. So almost I have completed all the concepts. I tried to complete. Okay. Is it clear? Okay. I will show that. Okay. Teja, got it? Completed, right? Up to this? Okay. Yes, so this is about synopsis. Some more formulas are there, some more shortcuts are there, okay? So due to lack of time, I can't explain all of them today. See, I think lengthiest session synopsis over today. Correct, no? So let us try to solve few questions, okay? Let us try to solve few questions. Application problem on Wheatstone Bridge. Yeah, that we'll solve during problem solving session, okay? Yes. So let us move on to questions. Okay, slideshow. Is it visible? Is it visible or I have to share it? No. Now? Yes? Yes, okay. So let us move on to the next question. Yeah. Yes. Answer to this. In an ionized gas, mobile charge carriers are. See, there are. How many types of mobile charge carriers are there? In solids. Yeah, in solids, free electrons. Okay. Then, in gas, in liquids, what do we call? In liquids, charge carriers, ions. Yes, positive and negative ions. Right? In electrolyte, positive and negative ions. Okay. So, which one? Gas. In gas, what are the charge carriers? Yes, that is the question here. In ionized gas, so ionized gas, the question itself, electron and positive ion. In ionized gas, the mobile charge carriers are. Yes. Is it visible now? Yes. So what about the answer? What about the first one? Previous question? Yes. What about this? Yes, it is option C. Okay, it is option C. Option C. Yes. Then what about second one? Second one. What do you have to calculate? N value you have to calculate. So what do you get? I equal to, sorry, problem is there. Yeah, no, it is okay. So I equal to Q by T. Right, so I equal to NE by T. So N equal to IT by E. So just substitute the values. So what is I? 1 into 10 to the power minus 3. Time per second, right? Per second, that means 1. E, 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. Yes, calculate this. Number you will get. Option C, someone says option C. Correct? Yes, yes. Option C you must get. Yes, it is option C. Shall we move on to next one? Next question? Shall we move on to next question? Yes, yes. Okay, yeah. I gave an expression for resistivity, right? If N, E, and tau. N, E, tau, and M are representing electron density, charge, relaxation time, and mass of an electron, respectively, then resistance of wire of length L and area of cross-section area A is given by. Relaxation time and mass of an electron, respectively. Then the resistance of the wire of length L and cross-section area. Yes. Resistance you have to calculate. You have to calculate resistance. Length L and area of cross section A. Okay, resistance. What is the value of resistance? Yes. R is nothing but rho L by A, right? R is nothing but rho L by A. Rho value you know. So what is rho? Rho is nothing but M divided by N E square tau. Just substitute that here. Yes, no doubt regarding this, right? It is clear now. Just substitute the value of rho. Okay, yes. Let us move on to the next one. Yeah. Use shortcut for this. Two copper wires have their mass. So mass ratio you have to consider. And length, relation between mass and length. Ratio of resistance. So relate resistance, mass, and length. Yes. Yes. Direct. R proportional to L square by M. Right? R proportional to L square by M. Yes. So R1 by R2 that is equal to L1 by L2 whole square into M2 by M1. Just substitute the values. Okay. What is mass ratio 2:1? Length ratio 3 by 4 whole square into what is M2? 3 by 2 whole square. So what do you get? 9/16 into 9. 4. Correct? Correct now? This is 3 by 4, right? Yes. Sorry. So what do you get? 9/16 into M2 by M1. What is that? 3/2, right? 27 by how much? 32, right? yes, yes, sorry. Got it? Yes. Madhumita, Shashank. Yes. Shall we move on to the next one? Yes, yemiga square illa nanu correct yemiga square illa ile okay sari alla yes next question ga hogwa yeah yes hede first law and second law first law and second law first law yavudra mele basis of based on conservation of charge second law based on conservation of energy yes nodi eshtu fast helta idire khushi aagta ide ivattu alwa now synopsis lengthy hodru paravagilla questions bega bega hogta ide ivattu hoda ha nee ee tara solve maade namige khushi aagutte na ond ishtu class maadi nee ee tara solve maadidre khushi aagutte namage ha idakka answer heli ivaga ade khushiyalli idakka answer heli If current flowing in a conductor changes by 1%, power consumed. नोड़े टापा 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 बोल रहे थे आंसर. Power ये ले रहे हैं ना I square R अंत ये ले दालो हाँ. So delta P by P is nothing but 2 into delta I by I. So 2 into yes to 1%. ये ले रहे थे तो. सरिया सरिया ನೋಡಿ ಎರರ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಇಂದ ಓಕೆ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಆ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನೆಗ್ಲಿಜಿಬಲ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ current through resistor ಎಷ್ಟು ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ ವೈ ನಾಟ್ ವಿ ಐ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲಲ್ಲ ಅಜ್ಮೀನಾ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ದಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಡಾಟಾ ಗಿವನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಐ ಅಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ದೇ ಹಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಐ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಥಿಂಗ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ಸಾರಿ ಪವರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ power and I in previous problem power and I so ideradakke relate maadbek neevu alli v could you know I bek namage nodi nodi alli ha idakke enagutte aamele nodu idakke enagutte heli steady state current through you know current through resistor alla okay resist current through capacitor en heli nange current through capacitor eno zero alwa ಆ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಝೀರೋ ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಯ್ತು ನೋ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿಸ್ ನೋ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿಸ್ ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡುವ ಈ ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಅನ್ನ ನೆಗ್ಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದನ್ನ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸೊ ಹೌ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಯ್ತು ಇದ್ರ ಅದು ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಸೊ ಇದೆರಡು ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲ್ ಇದೆ ಆ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಗೆ ಇದು ಸೀರೀಸ್ ಇದೆ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಆರ್ ಇಕ್ವಿವಾಲೆಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಈ ತರ ಬರೀಬಹುದು ನೀವು ಟೂ ಇಂಟು ತ್ರೀ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಬೈ ಟೂ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಟೂ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಏಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಹೇಳಿ ನಂಗೆ ಆರ್ ಇಕ್ವಿವಾಲೆಂಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಹೇಳಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ ಆರ್ ಇಕ್ವಿವಾಲೆಂಟ್ ಫೋರ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಕ್ವಿವಾಲೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೋರ್ ಎಸ್ R equivalent you will get it as 4 okay so R equivalent 4 adre iga nanige en kelidda alli I kelidda current through 2 ohm kelidare 2 ohm maadbekidre nanige branch current use maadbeku okay 2 ohm maadbekidre current through 2 ohm current through 2 ohm maadbekidre branch current formula we have to use okay so hagire eno current branch current bekidre resistance of other branch gottire 3 gottire total current beku hagire total current calculate maadi I equal to V by R equivalent, so V is 6. R equivalent is 4. So is taito 1.5 banta. I is 1.5. Therefore, I1, let us consider this as I1. So I1 idu I2 anta golle. So I1 equal to, you know, branch current formula. Branch current formula. Okay. So I1 equal to enagutte makale. Total current I into 3 ohm divided by sum of these two. 2 plus 3. Here enaitu I is to 1.5 into 3 divided by 5. Yes, barate nodi. Yes, barate. 0.9. Sorry. You're right. 0.9. Steady state alli adra moolaka pass agalla. Capacitor moolaka current pass agalla. ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ನಿನ್ನೆ ಕೂಡ ಅಂತದ್ದೇ ಒಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ ನಾವು. ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಥ್ರೂ. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿರ್ಬೇಕು ನಿಮಗೆ, ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್ ಎಲೋಸ್ ಎಸಿ ನಾಟ್ ಡಿ ಸಿ, ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಅದು? ಓಕೆ, ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್ ಎಲೋಸ್ ಎಸಿ ನಾಟ್ ಡಿ ಸಿ. ಹಾ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ತಮಾಷೆ ಇದೆ, ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕಾ? ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಓಕೆ. ಇದು ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಕಂಪನಿ ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇಳಿದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಅಂತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್ ಎಲೋಸ್ ಎ ಸಿ ನಾಟ್ ಡಿ ಸಿ, ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ. ಓಕೆ, ಅದು ಯಾವ ಆತರ ಯಾಕೆ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ, ನೀವು ಎಷ್ಟು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಆತರ. ಓಕೆ, ನೀವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಥವಾ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಲ್ಲ, ನೀವು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಈಗ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬರಿಬೇಕಿದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಅಂತ ಆತರದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಗಳನ್ನು ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಹ್ಮ್, ಅಷ್ಟಾಗೋ ಒಬ್ಬ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಮಾಡಿದಂತೆ, ಏನ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾ ನೋಡಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ. ಇದು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಈ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ಇದು. ನಾನೀಗ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್ ಇದೆ, ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟರ್ ಇದೆ, ಇಟ್ ಎಲೋಸ್ ಎ ಸಿ ನಾಟ್ ಡಿ ಸಿ ಅಂತ, ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಡಿ ಸಿ ಹೇಗೆ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ನಾವು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನ? ಓಕೆ, ಡಿ ಸಿ ಅನ್ನ